There you go. Really decent bluegill. Good afternoon, folks. Here we are once again in Johnson County, Missouri, at my hometown honey hole. It's been about a month since I've been out here, and we've had a couple of really decent rains in the last month.
Oh, is that you being cutie rootie little boy? It's a pretty puppy with all kind of fur. Cutie rootie.
Hey Rudy, it's June 2023. Are you still cutie rootie? You're older and just as cutesy-wootsy. Look at that little puppy.
But the water level is still low. We're going to try to get out there and see what we can do today. Having experienced some recent success on vertical jigging, I'm going to be doing something similar, either with or without a float. And we're going to jump in the Pitt Boss today. For those of you that don't know what a Pitt Boss is, it's a one-man mini boat that converts to a kick float. It's basically an unbreakable float tube. Without further ado, let's get her done. Among the many reasons I like my Pitt Boss is because I don't wear waders, except maybe in the wintertime if I'm fishing really cold water, because I'm going to be sitting up out of the water. I've got a padded seat for it. I didn't bring it. Just kind of went with a standard stripped down basic model today. But you can already see how far I'm sitting up out of the water. And there are two configurations. Number one is the kick float configuration that I'm in right now. And the second is that it has a front enclosure that attaches to the front deck here and basically closes off all this area right here, so you have a totally enclosed boat. I like the ability to use it as a kick float. Uncle Josh. I found that crappie love mealworms, so I'm going to put one of those on this little whippy flippy rod and something else on the other rod. Pop her down. Oh, I think it's a steelhead. It's kind of scrawny for a steelhead. All right, buddy, see ya. The puzzle is, are they out away from the bank or are they on the bank? I don't know. A little nicer one. That's a decent size bluegill sitting on 8. That's the line we're looking for, see? That's the 9 line. Get on back to doing what you were doing. And the bobber down. There she is. That's a little girly. Healthy. See ya. Now something else that I like to throw on to a mealworm to make a combo meal, but that is a crappie nibble. I've got a bunch of different colors. I think white's a good color for them. I mean, who doesn't like a combo? I do. Did you hear me say crappie nibble on a combo meal? I bet you did. That's a healthy little crappie. I don't think he's going to be 10. You just happen to be right on 10.
Okay.
Okay, my other two-piece here. Same two rods I brought out last time. I have a Bobby Garland lure. Kind of an interesting looking thing. It's called a Baby Shad SwimR. Cajun Cricket. That's a pretty good color. Throw a little crappie nibble on this and it should work just fine. That's what that last fish was caught on. Banging the snot out of this jig. Crappie don't do all that circling stuff that bluegill do. I know another creature that spins around like you do.
All right, Rudy. I know. How you doing? Yeah. Today we're going to pretend that you're a bluegill, okay? So go to your start. Go to your start right there. Right. That's your start. And today you're going to be a bluegill. Come on up. Sit. Shake. Do you remember what a bluegill does? A bluegill spins. Yeah, spins. They spin and spin and spin and spin. And then they go this way. They spin and spin and then they go this way. And they spin and spin and spin. Well, Rudy, I know you're not a bluegill, but you do deserve a good treat. He's a very good boy. And a good spinner. Should I introduce you to that bluegill? No, you're not interested, are you?
Tell me who, what's his name? I'd like to meet him. I'm sure you would. Would you like a little nibble with your mealworm? Why, yes, I would. That sounds like a nice combination. There you go. That's a nice one. Very nice. Right at 8. See ya. I like this little tray. There's one on both sides. Because you can put your nibbles out there and reload real quick. You can always hope for a crappie. It's like Mr. BG's are pretty hot today. See ya. Something with a little more oomph. Oh, Mr. B. Wondered when he was going to show up. Well, come on in. Well, I better notify Sparky. Don't want him to miss out on this. Two scoops? Okay. This is another very, very flexible long pole, perfect for panfish. They can try to yank it out of their mouth, but the pole just keeps bending. Advantage, moi. Okay, last couple of fish were caught on something called a panfish assassin. It was adorned with both a chartreuse and a white crappie nibble. Giving them a little bit of Baskin Robbins here today. Okay, with the afternoon getting late, I'm gonna take this number two pole and just suspend it over the side to where the lure is down maybe 6 feet. Okay, Mr. Suspender, what'd you get? Two of them on now. Crazy. This looks like a familiar sight. The bass and a bluegill. I bet you guys don't even like each other. All right, let's get you unhooked. Bear with me. There you go. Really decent bluegill. Sparky-sized trophy bass. You get to go by first. Catch you later. Obviously, we caught a lot of bluegill. Crappie were not biting this particular time, and that's okay. We'll catch them next time. But once again, thanks for coming along, and from our house to your house, have a blessed week, and God bless.